Hi there, I'm Aparna, your personal coach, helping you upskill yourself to lead the life you desire. We're talking about comfort zones all this month, and today I am so happy to bring to you two conversations I had with two gorgeous women, both my friends, and I'm going to be asking them questions which I hope is going to help you move out of your comfort zone. Is obviously what made you move out of your comfort zone?
So I was working in the IT for 16 years and it had become a habit, working 9 to 5, taking care of home and everything. And because of my health reasons, I started meditating regularly. And once I started meditating, I think I became more conscious of my life, what I was doing and why I was doing it. And that, you know, made me realize that I like my job, but I'm not passionate about it. This is not my passion. So I need to quit. And at this stage in life, money was not the most important thing for me. That is also one thing which helped me. But still, I took a long time to decide. And finally, in 1 year, I decided and I quit. And I started doing what my passion is.
The biggest change was quitting my job and starting my business. So, and that till date sometimes brings shivers, and I have sleepless nights, I will admit it. It's been a little over a year that I did that. And so you and I were in the same organization, and we both know how comfortable we were, and it was a nice, a good job, a nice organization, but both of us felt that our aptitude was probably not being utilized to the maximum.
So it's not challenging.
It was not challenging enough, and nobody in my family has ever done business. So of course, the decision was met with a lot of no's and with a lot of "Are you crazy?" and "Why would you throw your entire 15 years of work ethic down the drain?" But I think that is what really puts you in that zone where you realize that it is now do or die. But then slowly after a while, things start falling in place, and then when people acknowledge it, when people kind of validate your idea, when the results start coming in for whatever change you make, you start having that confidence and you stop self-doubting yourself. I think that is
the crucial
the pivotal
stage,
moment, yes, wherein you no more doubt yourself. You say, "Fine, I took a decision. I'm out of that, the comfort zone. Now I think I'll save it." Now that you've taken a decision, how do you feel about it right now?
I feel awesome. I mean, I'm living much more consciously and I'm living much better life than what I was living earlier. So I'm deciding my life, not just, you know,
not an
drifting.
Autopilot.
Yeah.
I think it's the best decision that I took. It just freed me to do so many things that I never had the time to do initially. And now I think I'm more aware of how I'm spending my time. I am more cognizant of what a morning, what an afternoon, what an evening, and what at night should be, and what activities should be done. And how much, so I can actually plan my day, and
it
have
goes
that
the way
thing.
You plan it.
Yes,
actually.
there are no disruptors.
Yeah,
of course there are. You will always have some things going
contingencies. You
plan
for it,
and you will have some bit of emergencies always. But that's fine. But at least I think 90% of control is still with you. So it feels good. I feel liberated now, and I feel that this is not that bad.
There is a metaphor which basically says that the magic is outside of the comfort zone, right? And so what kind of a magic did you discover?
First magic is that I've become fearless. So not completely fearless, but a lot fearless compared to what I was. So one realization I had is most of the decisions which we are making in life are out of fear, not out of hope or love or positive feelings. So just because we fear, we do something, we don't think about it deeply. That's a big game changer. I mean, you can just, you know, take a jump and do something new because you don't fear anymore. You have hope.
The kind of business that I went to is totally different from what my education or whatever my qualifications were. So I was a business analyst, I was an expert in insurance, and then from there I went to plantscaping and providing green gifting or even relationship capital management. So it was a completely different thing, and initially I got a lot of flack from a lot of people saying that, you know, there's a lot of competition, unorganized competition in this sector. It's when I started meeting people and they started you know, taking my services and then repeat customer and then word of mouth. And that's when I realized that, you know, there is a lot of business, there is a lot of potential, people are getting what I'm trying to say. And that validation started coming from the customers, not from my friends and family,
right,
who felt compelled to validate my idea,
yeah,
but from completely unknown people. And they're saying, wow, you know, I think it makes sense to, you know, to do that, to whatever you're suggesting, I think it makes sense. That's when I realized that maybe I've realized that secret sauce of cracking this, and probably I'm not there yet, but I am on the right path. I think that's where the magic happened for me, and then I was like, yeah, wow.
Hi, I'm Kshama. I've worked in the IT for 16 years and now I work as a social worker and counselor. I'm very, very happy, and I did take a long time. And it's okay to think and take a long time, but you must move out of your comfort zone, because what lies on the other side is amazing.
Hi, I'm Shilpa Sudame. I'm the founder director of The Stock Market. It is a green gifting company. We have three different verticals in it. One is green gifting, one is plantscaping, and we also do research-based gifting, which is relationship capital management. So my message to all of you would be that once you get out of your comfort zone, you will realize that you're out of your autopilot mode, and there are so many opportunities out there that you can explore and you can excel at it. So you're not restricted to what structure that you were put in. So you can venture out of your structure, and you will realize that you'll start thriving once you're out of your comfort zone. Should you wish to reach out to these ladies, you can find their information in the description below. And of course, if you wish to comment on this video and your opinion on it, your suggestions are welcome. Please leave them in the comment section or reach out to me in any of the social media platforms I'm in. Do you think it's just the ladies who can take such kind of decision and not men? Well, you'll be surprised. Next week, I'm going to be talking to men who have really moved out of their comfort zones. Men who have taken very bold decisions and are so happy in what they are doing right now. So don't forget to check out that episode next week. But coming back to this video, if you like it, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Subscribe and also hit the bell button so you'll never miss an update from me. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful time. Bye.